guys, welcome sa ITS, Information Technology Skills. So habang tinitingnan ko yung mga comments nyo dun sa ibang video natin ng flowcharting and algorithm, merong nagtanong dun na how to compute the number and its exponent. Okay, so yun kasi ginagamit yun ng loop or repetition structure. So ano ba yung mga loop or repetition structure? Ito yung mga problems na paulit-ulit mong gagawin, or ito yung mga statements na paulit-ulit mong gagawin. So we have here an example. Create a flowchart that display hello 5 times. So ano yung paulit-ulit mong gagawin dyan to display the word hello? How many times? It is 5 times. Now, the output for that is this. Tignan nga natin kung 5 times nga ba talaga na print. We have 1, 2, 3, 4, and 5. So yung algorithm niyan guys, print hello, ilang beses daw, dapat 5 times siyang ma-print. So ang flowchart niyan guys, siguro sa inyo, yung iba iniisip ganito ang flowchart. Pipint mo lang naman 5 beses, edi ganyan ang gagawin mo. E paano kapag sinabing print hello 100 times? So 100 mong ilalagay yung ganyan.
Please no! No! No!
Kaya ginagamitan natin yun ng repetition structure, or yung tinatawag natin na loop. So ano nga ba yung repetition structure? Performs a specific action or statement a number of times until a condition is satisfied. Nakakatawang example ng repetition structure is yung nanay mo na paulit-ulit sa yung sinasabi yung isang activity hanggang hindi mo yun ginagawa. Diba, ganun kakulit yung mga nanay natin, naka-repetition sila or naka-loop yung mga sinasabi nila. This structure includes while loop, do while loop, and for loop. So, what is a while loop? Statement or block of statement that is repeated as long as the condition is satisfied. So, ibig sabihin, gagawin niya tong action na to or ulit, uulit-ulitin niya tong action na to as long as the condition is satisfied. So, we have the flowchart na meron kang condition. Kapag true siya, of course, you're going to perform the action. Tatanungin mo ulit yung condition. If satisfied pa rin siya, if no, you're going to do another action. An example nito guys, yung magpapaalam ka muna dun sa magulang mo before ka pumunta sa isang party. You're going to ask first the condition before doing the action. Let's have an example. Create a flowchart that asks the user if he or she wants to display the word hello. The answer may either be N for no, Y for yes. Sa problem pa lang na yan, you're going to ask first the user kung ano yung gusto niya, kung gusto niya bang i-display or hindi. So yung answer, pwedeng N para sa no at Y para sa yes. So yung algorithm niyan guys, you're going to ask first the user kung gusto niya i-display yung word na hello. So N for no, Y for yes. Kapag nag-yes or nag-enter si user ng Y, ipiprint yung hello. Then you're going to ask again the user kung gusto niya pa ulit iprint yung word na hello. So, hanggang nag-e-enter siya ng Y, nag-reprint ng paulit-ulit yung word na hello at tinatanong mo ulit siya hanggang mag-N or mag-no siya. N, wala naman nakalagay for N, so ibig sabihin mag-terminate. Example output, you're going to ask the user kung mag-enter siya ng word na hello. So, pag nag-enter siya ng Y, preprint yung hello and tatanungin mo ulit yung user. So, pag nag-enter ulit siya ng Y, magpreprint yung hello and tatanungin mo ulit yung user. So, pag nag-enter na siya ng N, that's the time mataterminate yung program. Okay, so the flowchart of that problem is, start natin, we have the terminal block na start. Then next, we have the initialization block. Inside initialization block, meron tayo nung word na answer that will be our variable. And initial value niya guys, empty. Naka-single quote muna siya. Bakit empty? Kasi yung value niyan, ibibigay ni user. It's either Y or N. So, di-display natin yung tanong natin na do you want to print the word hello? after displaying that, we're going to get the answer from the user. So, pwede mag-enter si user ng Y or N. So, paano natin malalaman kung Y yung sagot niya? We're going to ask. If the value of answer is equal to Y, ipiprint niya yung hello. So, after printing the hello, we're going to display again the question. And, paulit-ulit lang yan hanggang mag-enter si user ng N. So, once that the condition is false, magta-terminate yung program. The next, we have the do while loop. Ano nga ba yung do while loop? The action or statement is executed first before asking the condition. So, we have here the action. Then, after the action, tsaka mo lang tatanungin yung condition. After asking the condition, kapag true pa rin siya, pa-perform mo ulit yung action. But, once the condition is false, you're going to perform another action. Okay, an example of this guys, parang yung ginagawa natin, pupunta ka muna sa party before ka magpaalam. Man, dito ako sa bahay ni na 1. Overnight kami. So, pag okay si Mudra, overnight. Pag hindi, uuwi ka. So, ganun yung do while. Pumunta ka muna dun sa tropa mo before ka nagpaalam. An example of do while loop, we have create a flowchart that display the word hello. Then, ask the user if he wants to display it again. The answer may either be N for no and Y for yes. So, here, you're going to print first the word hello. Then, you're going to ask if he or she want to print it again. Yung algorithm natin dyan, guys. First, ipiprint mo muna yung hello. Then, next, you're going to ask the user kung gusto niya ulit ma-print. So, mag-enter si user ng N for no, Y for yes. Kung nag-enter si user ng Y, magpiprint ulit yung word na hello. Pag in-enter niya is N, magta-terminate yung program kasi wala namang nakalagay dyan sa problem na gagawin if N yung in-enter. The possible output for that, reprint niya muna yung word na hello and asking the user if you want to print it again. Kapag nag-enter siya ng yes, magpiprint ulit yung word na hello. Then, ask again the user kung gusto niya ulit mag-print. Pag nag-enter na siya ng N, magta-terminate na yung program. So, the flowchart for that, we have the terminal block start, the variable answer, then ipiprint muna natin yung word na hello. After printing the word hello, di-display natin yung question natin na do you want to print again? Okay? So, dyan part, tatanungin na natin or we're going to get the answer ni user. So, kung meron na tayo ng answer ni user, pwede na natin siyang tanungin if yung answer ba is equal to Y. So, pag that is true, preprint mo ulit yung word na hello and maglulup ulit siya hanggang dun sa condition. So, kapag yung condition naging false, that's the time na magta-terminate yung flowchart or yung program. Next loop, we have the for loop. Execute an action or statement repeatedly. There are many applications for for loop, including tasks such as reading through a list or initializing an array. So, pinaka-common na ginagamit na loop is the for loop. Bakit? Kasi ginagamit ito for counting. Kapag meron kang binibilang na actions, the syntax for for loop, we have first the initialization. Ano initialize mo dyan? Yan yung counter mo or yan yung tagabilang. Then, we have the condition. If the condition is true, you're going to perform an action. Then, after performing the action, meron tayong iteration. Ano yung iterate natin? The value of the counter. So, magbabago yung laman nung counter natin. And after that, babalik siya sa condition. Asking if the counter meets its condition. So, hanggang nami-meet ni counter yung condition, gagawin niya yung action. Pero once na na-meet na ni counter yung condition, it will perform other action. So, example tayo ng for loop. create a flowchart that display hello 5 times. Kung maalala nyo, ito yung first example natin kanina. So, yung output nga kanina, ito yun. And we have the algorithm to print the hello and ask if it is printed 5 times. So, ang gagawin niya, bibilangin natin kung na-print talaga yung word na hello 5 beses. So, yung in-introduce natin na flowchart kanina, yun yung maling paraan. So, paano nga kapag 100 times mong ipaprint yung hello word? Of course, hindi pwede yun. So, ganito ang flowchart niya. We have the initial block start. And we have the initialization. Sa loob niya, we have the counter equals to 1. So, yan yung initialization part ni for loop. The next, we have the condition. We're going to ask if the value of count is less than or equal to 5. Bakit less than or equal? Kasi, ang initial value ni count is 1, that is less than 5. And gusto natin bilangin yung print na hanggang 5. So, 5 is equal to 5. Dapat ma-print pa rin yung hello. So, if the condition is true, of course, it will going to print hello. That is the action. And yung iteration, guys, we have count plus plus. Yung plus plus, guys, that is a unary operator na na-discuss ko sa ibang video ko. Lalagay ko na lang sa description box or dun sa taas ng screen nyo yung link para mapanood nyo kung ano ang operators. So, count plus plus is the same with count equals to count plus 1. Ibig sabihin yan, magpa-plus ka ng 1 dun sa value nung count. So, for this flowchart, ang gagamitin natin, guys, is the count plus plus. So, after the iteration, tatanungin niyo ulit if the condition is true. Umabot na ba siya ng 5 or greater na ba siya ng 5? Pag greater na siya ng 5, that is false, magta-terminate na yung program. Now, let's try to simulate. Yung simulation pala, guys, we're going to trace kung paano nagra-run yung flowchart natin. So, for example, ito yung output. And sa initialization block natin, after the start, we have the count equals to 1. After the initialization block, meron tayong condition asking if count less than or equal to 5, the value of count is 1. 1 less than 5, that is true. Nagpiprint ka ng hello. Then, meron tayong iteration. Ibig sabihin, yung value ni count magiging 2. Now, ang condition natin dito is 2 less than 5. That is true. So, magpiprint ulit ng hello. Magka-iterate ka ulit, magiging 3. And as again the condition, if 3 less than 5, we all know that that is true. Magpiprint ulit siya ng hello. Mag-iterate ka ulit. Count plus plus. Pagiging 4. And we're going to ask again the condition if 4 less than 5. True pa rin siya, guys. Magpiprint pa rin ng hello. And mag-iterate ka ulit. We have 4 plus 1. We have 5. And 5 less than or equal to 5. That is true. Kaya magpiprint ka ulit ng hello. The next, after printing the hello, meron ulit iteration which is count plus plus magiging 6 ngayon yung counter natin. So, 6 less than or equal to 5, that is false. Ibig sabihin, magte-terminate na po yung program. So, ang output po niya, yung 5 lang na hello. That is an example of for loop. Let's have another example for for loop. Create a flowchart that allows the user to enter a number and display the number from 0 to the given number. So, dito, we're going to ask the user to enter a number. Tapos, i-display natin yung numbers from 0 hanggang sa binigay ni user na number. So, yung algorithm natin, guys, ask the user to enter a number, of course, and display the number from 0 to the number. Possible output for that is, let's say, enter a number. Yan yung prompt nagsasabi kay user na maglagay siya ng number. And si user nag-enter ng 9. So, ibig sabihin, iti-display niya yung 0 hanggang 9. Yan yung input. So, paano nga natin gawin yan into flowchart? Okay, so, idadraw na natin guys yung flowchart. First, we have the terminal block start. Then next, we have the initialization. Inside initialization, meron tayong count as the counter. So, mag-start siya ng 0 kasi yun yung kailangan natin i-print. 0 hanggang sa binigay ni user na number. And we also have the number. Initial value niya muna is 0. Kasi mababago naman yan kapag nag-enter si user ng number. Then next, we have the output block na ipiprint niya yung prompt natin na enter a number. Then, we're going to get the value of number from the user. So, after that, meron na tayo nung condition. Okay, so we're going to ask if the value of count is less than or equal to number. If that is true, ipiprint niya yung value ni count. Bakit yung count? Kasi yung count ang nagbibilang ng 0 hanggang umabot ng number na binigay ni user. Then we're going to iterate it into count plus plus. So kapag katapos na nung iteration, babalik ulit yun sa condition. So paulit-ulit lang yan hanggang maging false. Kapag nag-false na siya guys, that's the time na magto-terminate na yung program. So simulate natin. We have the count equal to 0. Then meron din tayong number equal to 0. So meron tayong mapiprint na enter a number, that is the prompt, and mag-enter si user ng number, for example 9. Yung value ng number ngayon magiging 9. So here we're going to have the condition na if 0 less than or equal to 9, saan nakuha si 0, that's the value of count, less than or equal to number, that is 9. So 0 less than or equal to 9, that is true, print 0. Then meron tayong iteration, count plus plus, magiging 1 yung counter natin, which is 0 plus 1 equals to 1. And we're going to ask again the condition if 1 less than 9. 1 less than 9, that is true, print again 1, the value of count. Count plus plus, magiging 2. And ask again the condition, 2 less than or equal to 9, that is true, print again the value of count. Fast forward, let's say umabot na tayo ng 8. 8 plus plus, that is 9. So, count now here is 9. 9 less than or equal to 9, that is true. Kaya pre-print pa rin natin yung 9. And meron ulit tayong count plus plus, magiging 10 na po siya. Babalik tayo sa condition, we're going to ask if 10 less than or equal to 9, that is false. Ibig sabihin, magto-terminate na yung program. So, let's have another example for for loop. Create a flowchart that allows the user to enter a number and display its factorial. So here, we're going to ask the user to enter again a number. Tapos, i-display natin yung factorial. So yung algorithm dyan guys, ask the user to enter a number. Then next, compute for the factorial. Kasi of course, wala tayong i-display na factorial kapag hindi natin siya kinompute. So how do we compute factorial? Sa calculator, we have n and the exclamation, n is the number, or you can have n times n minus 1 times n minus 2, or simply, yung factorial is the product of all numbers from the given number hanggang 1. After computing the factorial, you're going to display. Possible output for that, for example, meron tayong prompt na enter a number, and si user nag-enter siya ng 5. Ang output po niyan, each factorial is 120. So, paano siya naging 120? Meron tayong equation na factorial equals to 5 times 4 times 3 times 2 times 1. Saan nakuha yun? Yung 5 na in-enter ni user hanggang umabot ng 1. So, let's try to create the flowchart. Of course, we have the terminal block start and the initialization block. Meron tayong number. Yan yung i-enter ni user na number. And meron tayong factorial na equal to 1. Bakit equal to 1? Kasi kapag ginamit natin ang 0, we all know that 0 times a number is equal to 0. So, dapat 1 pa rin yung factorial. So, kailangan natin nung prompt na enter a number. And we're going to get the value of number from the user. After getting the value from the user, we're going to have the condition asking if number is greater than or equal to 1. So, tulad nga nang nakita nyo kanina, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. So, yung number ang nagbabago. Yung number ang magiging counter natin ngayon. So, if the number is greater than or equal to 1, compute natin yung factorial. Meron siyang formula or equation na factorial is equal to factorial times the current value ng number. And meron tayong iteration na number minus minus. Itong minus minus, same with plus plus kanina, unary operator. This is the same with number equals to number minus 1. For this example, gagamitin natin yung number minus minus. And after the iteration, as again the condition. So, magka-continue itong loop na to hanggang yung value ng number is greater than or equal to 1. So, ibig sabihin, kailan mag-i-stop ito kapag yung value na ni number is maging 0. So, if the condition is false, it will print the result. Okay, so we have the, its factorial is plus the factorial. For yung plus, guys, that is concatenation. Yung concatenation, magkakaiba. Depende kung ano yung programming language na ginagamit nyo. And after displaying the result, magta-terminate na yung program. So, simulate natin, guys. We have number equals to 0. Yun po yung nasa loob ng initialization block. Then, we have factorial equals to 1. So, yung output natin, first, magpa-prompt muna siya, asking the user to enter a number. Mag-enter say a number na, let's say, 5. So, yung value ni number ngayon maging equals to 5. After entering a number, ask the condition if number is greater than or equal to 1. So, 5 greater than or equal to 1, that is true. We're going to perform the operation, which is factorial equals to factorial times number. So, we have here factorial equals to 1 times 5. So, nakuha si 1, that is the current value ni factorial, times 5, that is the current value of the number. So, dito sa part na to, magbabago yung value ni factorial. So, 1 times 5, ang value ngayon ni factorial is 5. Then, meron tayong iteration na num minus minus magiging 4 ngayon yung number. Then, we're going to ask again the condition. 4 greater than or equal to 1, that is true. Perform the operation. Factorial times number, that is 5 times 4. Ang magiging value ngayon ni factorial is 20. Then, mayroon tayong iteration ulit. Magiging 3 na yung number. As again, the condition, 3 greater than or equal to number. Perform the operation. So, 20, the current value of factorial times 3. Magiging 60 yung factorial. And, number minus minus ulit. Magiging 2. 2 greater than or equal to 1. That is true. So, 60 times 2, magiging 100, 20 ngayon yung factorial. Then, another iteration, magiging 1 ngayon si number. 1 greater than or equal to 1, that is true again. So, meron tayong equation na 120 times 1, that is 120 pa rin. Yun na yung current value ni factorial. So, meron another iteration, number minus minus, so 1 minus minus, that is 0. As again the condition, 0 greater or equal to 1, false na po yung sagot. So, mangyayari, we're going to print its factorial is 120. So, after printing that, terminate the program. So, guys, kung meron pa kayong mga problems na hindi nyo alam or yung gusto nyong itackle natin dito later on, mag-comment lang kayo dyan sa baba para ma-discuss natin sa mga susunod na video. So, that's it, guys. Kung may katanungan pa kayo, just comment down below at sasagutan natin yan isa-isa. Para sa iba pang tutorial videos, just visit this video. And of course, don't forget to subscribe at hit ang notification bell for more tutorial videos. Bye!